Okay, so you're working on your side project and it's gaining some traction. But guess what? Before you get into the next batch of Y Combinator, you're gonna need some functionality that really makes your application pop. And one piece of functionality that always sets an app apart from another is real-time communication and updates through WebSockets. And I've done this with my task application right here. Check this out. I have two different clients logged in. They're both connected through WebSockets to the same channel. So if I type a message in one task, I'm working on this, that message will show up in the other screen. And then if I type it over here, don't worry about it, it shows up in both as well. Thanks to Action Cable, I can easily have users chatting in real time in their task show pages. And thankfully, it's just a little bit of code. But what if I told you that this app wasn't using something like Redis, and instead it was pulling a database for updates? Well, with Solid Cable, this works amazingly well, and we get to drop a dependency. Let's get into it. So before we get into actually implementing Action Cable and Solid Cable with our task application, let's go over really quickly how Action Cable used to work in previous Rails versions and how Rails 8 handles it with Solid Cable. So let's go over really quickly the setup for real-time updates and WebSockets using Action Cable, okay? So let's say we have a client. Actually, let's say we have two clients. Let's give them heads. That looks really nice. And let's say each one of these clients wants to connect to our application using WebSockets. They can connect to our application using Action Cable. And then when an event happens, Action Cable will push this event to a store, which typically is Redis. Now, one thing to note here that in previous versions with Action Cable, there is actually a database adapter for Postgres that uses the built-in notify functionality for Postgres. So it'll act similar to how Redis acts in this setup. But one problem with that is it only allows you a maximum of 8 kilobytes per message. So that could be a problem if your messages are bigger than 8 kilobytes, just something to keep in mind. So now when an event happens and Redis receives the event, it acts as something like a message broker. And so it'll push this message back out to Action Cable, and then Action Cable will broadcast its message to all the clients connected at that channel. So now let's go over how the current Rails 8 application sets things up with Solid Cable. I'll just write Solid Cable. So now let's say we have two clients just like before, and they're super happy because we made a really great app for them, and they both want to connect to our application using real-time updates with WebSockets. Now in our application, we will use Action Cable with the Solid Cable database adapter. And so now in this setup, when an event happens, Action Cable will push that event to a database, but this database isn't just Redis living on RAM. This is any database we want to use, like MySQL, Postgres, and SQLite. Those are the ones that are supported right now. Now let me just try and draw a database really quickly around this. Yeah, that'll do. And so now a key difference here is that Action Cable will push the event to a database, and Solid Cable will be polling this database for new updates. And then when Action Cable sees that a new event was pushed to the database through its poll, it will then fetch this event from the database and push it to Action Cable, where Action Cable will then broadcast this message to anyone connected to this channel. So what's interesting with Solid Cable is that we actually wind up with a slightly simpler setup. We only have to use our current database in order to store messages that Solid Cable can then pull for, fetch, and use Action Cable to broadcast our messages. This allows us to drop Redis as a dependency, and it'll save us money in the long term because we don't need a large RAM store. We can actually just use our hard drives to store messages. Not to mention, this gives us a little bit more flexibility in the amount of space we can use for any given message. Just something to keep in mind. Now, before we go ahead and implement Solid Cable in this application, we first have to implement our WebSocket communication. As of right now, we have a pretty basic web app that allows users to chat on their tasks using messages. Now, we have a messages form here where I can type this is a message. And when I click on send, we see that we get a new message in this messages list under our task show page. However, this is not currently using WebSockets. Let's give a brief tour of what we're doing here. Let's open up our application and go to our task show page. And we can see under tasks show that we have our form for a new message. Now, the message is a model that we created outside of this video. And it's a pretty simple model that just has some content that is text, and it belongs to a task and belongs to a user. So a user can see all of the messages that belong to that task when they're looking at the task show page. Now back to our task show page, we have a form that will allow a user to create a new message. And when that message is created, we can render all of our tasks messages right here. And that partial for rendering our task messages exists right here under app views, messages, message. So it's a pretty simple setup, and we can see in our messages controller, when our form actually submits, we hit the create action. And it's a, again, contrived example, but we basically just create a new message for this task. We then add the current user as this message's user, and we save the message, and then we redirect back to our task path. So although this functionality looks really nice, all we're really doing is creating a new message and then redirecting back to the task show path. So really all we're doing is refreshing the page, so to speak. Okay, so now let's configure this application so that it uses WebSockets instead of just redirecting back to the task show page. Now there's two kind of sections we want to set up here. One is the solid cable section, which we'll get into right now. And then we're going to actually want to handle the action cable side of things, which is actually implementing the WebSockets on the client side. So let's configure solid cable for development for this application. So let's open up our application and go to config database.yaml so that we can configure the database we're going to use for solid cable. And we can see down here, we already have our development key, which has our primary and our cache database configurations. And our cable configuration is going to be very similar to the cache configuration, which is something we did in a previous episode in this series. So let's just copy our cache configuration and paste it below. And we want to change this key's name to cable from cache, because this is our solid cable configuration. Our database now is not going to be named Life Task Planner Development Cache. We're going to name it Life Task Planner Development Cable. And our migrations paths is actually going to be cable migrate, not cache migrate. And of course, under this key here, we are going to inherit from the SQLite anchor, which we set up here again in a previous episode, so that we're using SQLite for our solid trifecta, which is going to be solid cache, solid cable, and solid queue. Solid queue is going to be in a different episode. And we have Postgres set up for our regular database, just for our models and everything else to be stored. The next file we want to open up is our config cable.yaml file. And this is going to tell solid cable which database we want it to point to. We can see in our development environment, the default adapter is async, but we want to change that to be solid cable. Now we can get a clue down here in our production setup that our adapter is solid cable. So let's copy this and actually push this under our development key. So now under development, our adapter is going to be solid cable, and it's going to connect to the database of cable. Now this name matches the key we used over here in our config database.yaml file. So make sure those two match. And our polling interval is 0.1 seconds, which means that's how fast solid cable is going to poll our database for updates for messages. And the message retention is 1 day. Now we can leave our editor and run bin rails db migrate. And that's essentially all the configuration you need for solid cable, at least in development. So now let's configure the rest of our application to actually open up a WebSocket and communicate with solid cable and action cable through WebSockets when we create a new message. This part is going to be fun. So now let's go to our task show page, and somewhere down where we're rendering our task messages, we want to add a new tag for turbo stream from, and we want to call our channel task messages. Right now, what this tag does is it opens up a new connection through a WebSocket to Action Cable, and it's gonna wait for turbo events. And now that we're going to be listening for WebSockets, we don't need our controller to redirect back to the task show page. We can actually change that up a little bit to do something different. And in fact, all I'm going to do here, because this is again just a contrived example here, you would do probably something a little bit different in production, but right here I'm just going to render essentially nothing, which is an empty JSON object with the status of no content. Now we don't want any content to come back here because we're going to communicate through WebSockets, not through this controller endpoint, if that makes sense. And so now what we want to do is actually broadcast to this new channel that our turbo stream from is connected to. We want to broadcast a message that it can then pick up through solid cable and action cable. So how do we broadcast that? Well, let's go to our model message. And in our message model, what we want to do is create an after create hook on this model. So now we want to define broadcast message. And within here, what we want to do is we want to call broadcast append to. Now this is a special method that we can use that will create a new turbo event that we can then target a certain part of our application with. Let's walk through it really quick. So broadcast append to takes a lot of arguments. Now the first one is going to be the name of the channel. If you remember, we created a channel, it was named task messages. So we want to broadcast to our task messages channel. And then we also have a target, and the target is going to be a div with the ID of messages. Now, if we go back to our tasks show page, let's just open that up really quick. in our task show page, you can see right here that we have a div with the ID of messages that wraps whatever we're rendering for our current messages here. So what's going to happen is in our broadcast message, we're going to append a new turbo stream event to the messages div. Okay, let's keep going. Now, what are we appending to this div? Well, we're going to append a partial, and the partial is called messages message. You remember earlier, we actually talked about this partial. It is the thing we use to render our task messages. We can just reuse it for this as well. It's a pretty simple partial. It's going to work great. And in this partial, we're going to want to pass some locals because it's going to need some information to render. And the locals are message, which is the only attribute that this partial needs. And the message is the current class that we're in. We're in a message that we just created. So we pass self. Okay, so now let's just restart our server and we can go to our application and hit refresh. So now we're on our task show page and everything looks kind of the same, but let's inspect our network calls here. And we can see that we actually have a new connection called cable. This is a connection that was upgraded to a WebSocket. So now this is a WebSocket. Again, this came from the turbo streams from tag that we created in our task show page. This has opened up a new WebSocket. It's created a channel that's named after task messages, and it is subscribed to that channel. Okay, so ideally what's going to happen here is when we create a new message, let's just go back to our code again really quick to walk ourselves through it. We go to our messages controller. It will respond with a no-op essentially, so that's fine. And then in our messages model, if I could type correctly, we hit the broadcast message method on our after create hook for this model. So what should happen is we create a new turbo event that should append to the messages target on this channel, which is called task messages. It'll use this partial, which is messages message, and it'll pass this local along as part of the data. So let's create a new message and let's see what happens. I'm gonna click send and okay, we got an update. This is great. Now it looks very similar to what we did before, but we can see over here in our inspector, we can see that in our cable, we have a new event. And this is what the broadcast append to method does for us. It created a new turbo event, and we know that it's a turbo event because it is a partial that's wrapped with this turbo stream element that has an action, which is append, and our target. These are all of the arguments that we gave this broadcast append to method. And we have our template over here, which is the partial that we're rendering. Now, if we go back to our application and check our logs, we can see that Solid Cable has inserted this message into a database and it has then streamed through Turbo this event. So now we have an end-to-end solution where we have WebSockets and Solid Cable polling for these events from our database, broadcasting them out to anyone who is subscribed, and it's just that easy. It didn't even take that much code. So now let's just test this out again. Let's just make this half the screen over here, make a new incognito window right here, and let's go to our local host and we can log in with a different user. Our user on the left hand side is 1@example.com. We're going to log in as 2@example.com, and our password is password. Don't take that password, by the way. I'm going to production with it. I don't want you telling anyone. Okay, got it. Good. So now let's sign in with this user. We can click on this first task right here and then let's type a message. Did you do this yet? And then there we go. We have real-time updates across multiple clients that are connected to the same channel using Turbo Streams, all using WebSockets, and it's Solid Cable under the hood so that we can only use our database. We don't have to worry about Redis and our RAM store. This is amazing. So we just added chat functionality to our application in probably the easiest way I've ever seen. Under the hood, we have real-time updates via WebSockets, and we didn't even have to write any JavaScript code. And now with Solid Cable, we can remove yet another dependency from our tech stack, because now we're just using our database to handle the message brokering action that Redis used to handle. And that feels really nice. Rails 8 is meant to make things as simple as possible to build amazing apps from Hello World to IPO. And I can't imagine it getting much easier than this. So Solid Cable is amazing. Check it out. And hey, thanks, nerds.